I don't know how long I'm going to live. 20 years, 30 years, 10 years, 5 days, I don't know. None of you know how long you're going to live. None of us know whether we had a life like this before or whether we'll have a life like this after. All we know is we have some time. I don't know your time, you don't know my time, none of us know our time. But we know one thing, it's a limited time. And that might end any day. We don't know when will it end. So we have a time frame. So it is very, very important to know what are we going to do in the time frame. This time frame is nothing but our life. What are we going to do in our life? Let us assume I call one of you and say, take the car from here and then drive till someplace. I don't tell the name, say just drive. You ask me, where are you asking me to go? I'm telling a lot of people are going in this road. You also go along with them, just drive. Then you also start driving the car. You are just going on and on and on, and after a while, you're getting really anxious and frustrated. You really don't know where you're going, but you're thinking everyone are going in this road. Maybe I'm also going somewhere. Let them, they're also going, I'll follow them. And then you get anxious, you get frustrated. You don't enjoy the company of people inside the car. You don't enjoy the ambience, the trees around you. And then you suddenly see a guy overtaking your car. You're thinking, maybe he's getting something which I'm not getting. Am I missing something? You don't allow him to go. You also compete with him, and then you go for a while. And then you take a left somewhere with an indicator, and then you think, am I taking the right left? Is it correct? And then you look for acknowledgement from everyone around you. This is what happens to 90% of people in this world. They exactly don't know what they want to do in their life. What do? They just travel with everyone else. And then they compete with someone. Someone is taking a certification course. They don't know whether it's their part, their cup of tea. They just take their certificate and course because they feel, am I missing something here? And then they get frustrated. They get anxious. And then they look for acknowledgement from the entire society, from everyone around them. Am I doing the right thing? On the contrary, let us assume, I call one of you and tell, take this car, go to Kozhikode. I have 8 hours time for you. This is the place you need to go. This is how you need to reach. From the moment you start, you have 100% clarity of what is that you want. You drive peacefully, you enjoy the company inside the car, you don't become anxious, you don't get frustrated, you enjoy the journey. If someone is going very fast, probably you'll know, I have 3 more hours, I have 20 more kilometers. Why am I competing with this guy? He's going to a different destination, he has his own timeline. You will not compete with that person, and then you'll enjoy it. And then if you want to take a left, you'll put an indicator and take a left. You will never ask anyone, you will never have a self-doubt. You'll be 100% confident. You'll be like, yes, I need to take this left to reach Kozhikode. That is what happens in life. A whole lot of transformation if you know what exactly you want to do in your life. It is very important to know that. I was born in a town called Singanallur in Coimbatore district in Tamil Nadu. I was a small, young, coward boy. Used to be scared of dogs, cats, crackers, people who talk a lot and whatnot. I didn't have any clue about life. All I knew was my friends in front of my house in the street where we used to play until my dad passed away when I was 12 years old. Then there was a sudden change or transformation in the whole life. Things that were very smooth and normal were not smooth. It were difficult, it were challenging. But my mom was a brave woman, so luckily she made me face all the challenges together along with her, which made me a brave man, ready to take any responsibilities that I want to. But one thing that I learned there is nothing is permanent. Be it my father, or you, or me, or anything. Nothing is permanent. If nothing is permanent, if we are not permanent, then the materialistic possessions, the power, the money, the fame, all of it that we have, nothing is permanent. I was not a studious student. My mother literally struggled me to get through 10th standard. And if she would have written the examination, she would have got a better score. But somehow I managed, and I found her struggling to put me in a diploma education in one college. Then I thought maybe I'm troubling her a lot. I should get a good job, I should earn well, and I should give them some money, and I should not trouble them a lot. This is the time, 15, 16 years, all of us, I am no exception, will get introduced to this term called getting settled in life. A myth which we all get introduced to. You should get good score in 10th standard, you should study well, you should get a car, you should get a bungalow, you should get married, you should get settled in life, you should earn well. That's all. My perspective about life was that, because I was also in sync with that idea. So people told, if you want to get settled in life, do very well in diploma. I did well. They said study well. I was a topper or a second rank holder. They said do well, perform well. I was the best outgoing student. They said you should get a job. I got a job. Then someone told me, no. If you just stop with diploma, you'll not be able to settle in life. It's just a primary education. You should go for a B. On a lighter note, one of my neighbor told, you'll not get a girl to marry. I was really worried if you just stop with diploma. And then I pursued further to join B in PhD Tech, one of very good colleges. Then people said, getting an admission in PhD Tech is not easy. You got one, so do well, get settled in life, study well. I studied well. They said, perform well. I was a student secretary, perform well. And then they said, you need to get a job to get settled in life. I got placed in TCS. And then my whole family, uncle, aunt, niece, grandfather, grandmother, all of them came along with me, stood in the railway station with all sweets and all joy. They said to me, yes, you're going to get settled in life. Go join TCS. Amazing. Do whatever you want. I was so happy that I'm going to get settled in life, which I've been told from the age of 16. I finally thought all those assignments and laboratory and homework, all those things are done. I'm going to get settled in life. I joined. I went. 3 weeks. Amazing. Third week, I realized, this is not my cup of tea. I don't want to do this in my life. Software is not my cup of tea. TCS is a great concern. Software is a great industry. But that's not my cup of tea. You know what's the most difficult thing in life? The most difficult thing in life is to do something which you don't like from morning till evening, even though you get paid for. I used to wonder why my friends and seniors, they always say we are waiting for weekends, we are waiting for holidays when they were working for a company. I was so much able to connect to them. I was also waiting for weekends. I was also waiting for holidays. But the myth of getting settled in life was so strong inside me, I couldn't quit. I pursued further. But believe me, when you join a company, the kind of designation you get, the beautiful infrastructure of the company, the salary package that you get, and the brand name of the company, all these things will attract you. First month, yeah, you get a salary, you'll be happy, you'll get some things for your family. Fifth month, that money is just a piece of paper. The designation you'll not even remember. The whole infrastructure or ICE will be closed. The company brand name you're not bothered about. All it matters is, what are you doing here? Are you enjoying what you're doing? I quit. I've decided, what should I do next? From my childhood, after a lot of introspection, I realized that I like taking responsibilities, be it a student leader, and making a smaller positive impact for a smaller community. In real world, that is politics. Then I've decided I'll join politics. I quit. I joined a startup in Coimbatore. I came back to Coimbatore. I was already a member of a party from the age of 18. I started working. Post which, I've never looked for weekends, weekdays. Everything was good. Then I joined. Then I thought, I want to work in a larger scale, the bigger responsibility. The then Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu, she was my role model. I want to work with her. Then one of my boss, whom I was working with, he told me, probably you get into some IIM, and then don't take placements, improve your skill until you want to work for this party, this organization, this state, this people of this state. That will probably send a strong signal to you, to everyone, that so that you will know, okay, this is what you want. And people will think, maybe this guy is serious, we'll give him something. I believed in it. 2011, March, he told me, I prepared a flowchart in my house. Crat cat, get into IIM, become a student leader, opt out of placements, and then work for a larger responsibility for the party. This is what I wrote and kept in front of my almirah. 11, I couldn't crack. 12, I couldn't crack. 13, I cracked. 14, I've become the general secretary of IIM Ahmedabad. 15, I opted out of placements. I never had a second opinion because I really knew what I want. So I, in spite of my friends having a hefty paid package, I was very comfortable. I opted out of placements and nothing happened. I was waiting for a month. Nothing happened. Waiting for a couple of months. Nothing happened. Then I got married to one of my batchmates from IIM A. On fine day, I and her, both of us, we were watching a movie inside a theater. 15th minute, my mom calls me and says, hey, you have been appointed as the state AIIMK IT wing secretary by the CM. News, you are all over the news. I said, no, it should be someone else. He said, no, you are the one. I came out in the 20th minute. Then 2011 March, I prepared this flowchart. 2016, 23rd March, I met her. I took the responsibility, and there was a whole lot of change inside me. And I was so happy about it. Believe me, if you write what you want in a piece of paper, put it in front of you and work towards it, if you have a plan, it will work. Because when you put it in front of you, even though if you don't read every day, subconsciously it will hit you, it will go inside you, the thought will always be inside you, and it will be going up and up and up. I always believe, if you are so passionate about something, and if you really want something, and if you passionately work towards it, your relatives, your friends, your family, the animals, the trees, the sun, the moon, and the star, the entire universe will work for you. You will be guided and taken through in the path, but if you know what you want. Then people ask me, did you waste an MBA degree for it? I used to tell them, boss, if you want someone to sell a soap and a shampoo, FMCG products, if you want an MBA degree, a constituency with 5 lakh constituents, managing a complex problem, I always feel an IIM Ahmedabad degree is an underqualification. Then they tell me, okay, then you used IIM A for this? Of course, yes. What is education? If your education is not facilitating you, not helping you to get what you want in your life, that degree is just mere piece of paper in your almirah. You're not going to use it. So it should help you improve the skills. It should help you kind of create opportunities. Only if you know that you want to have ice cream, if you go in a road, you will be able to, your eyes will pop up for all ice cream counters. If you don't know, your eyes will not pop up. Say, let's assume you like one particular variety of car. Then the next week when you travel in road, wherever you see, you will feel like seeing that car. That is not because the company has understood and they have put more cars in front of you to kind of attract you. It is because your eye is recognizing what you want. So if you know what you want, you can use your education wisely. You can look for opportunities. Say one of you want to become a politician, you can connect with me after this session because you know what you want. But if you don't know, you will not be able to use the opportunities. So I decided this is what I want to do and it really helped me. How to go about it? How exactly you should know what is that you want to do in your life? First, accept you don't know what is that you want to do in your life. If you accept, then automatically your mind will start thinking in that direction of, okay, then what is that I want to do? I don't know, I need to figure out. Second, think something, take a piece of paper, write 24 hours, 365 days, what is something that you can do? You'll never get bored of. You'll really love doing it. The whole day, the whole night, what is that? Third, do we have some skills, intrinsic skills, attitude and other things towards that? Like, for example, I want to become a singer. If I'm passionate about it, let's assume. If I sing, all of you will run out of this hall because I don't possess that skill set. So you need some skill set or you should be able to improve that skill set. And third one, the feasibility. Say today I'm saying I am passionate about rocket science. I have the skill set. I can build the entire rocket, but I just need 10,000 crores. It is externally, extrinsically, it is not feasible. You might not have the money right now. So you look for an area which will overlap all three areas, all these three aspects that are very important. But I will give high weightage to passion. If you are passionate about, then other things will just come behind you. You need not worry about it. Apart from all these things, assume that you're dead tomorrow. Tomorrow morning, 10 o'clock, you're dead. Then definitely your mom, your father, your wife or husband, your children, your siblings, your relatives, all of them will be crying, oh my God, I'm missing my brother, my sister, my son, what not. But what do you think the world will be missing? I'm sure you all want to create a void when you're not there. When Kalam sir was not there, we missed a great scientist, we missed a great teacher, right? What is that you want the world to miss when you leave this world? That is something you can really think of. So write all these things, connect this emotional approach together. It might take a day or a month or a year, but if you think in the direction, you will definitely be able to identify what is that you want to do in your life. Then people ask me, what about the parents? Parents will not agree to what I say. Parents will not understand. Boss, if you can't convince your parents, then you are not convinced, first of all. If you are not able to convince your parents, you will not be able to convince any customer tomorrow if you are in a business. You will not be able to convince anyone because you have been living with your parent for 30 years. You know how they are going to respond for any kind of situation they are in. So you can accordingly talk to them and they are the one who care for you the most. You should be able to. But if you are convinced, not only your parents, you will be able to convince any person in the world, irrespective of whether you know that language or you don't know that language. It's very, very important. Then people ask me, what about this society? Society will always say a big no. Whatever you do, whenever you do, they will say, no, please don't do that. Because the entire society is traveling in the route without knowing where they are going. They are just thinking, everyone are going there, let me also go. If you suddenly take a different route, they will definitely call you and tell, obviously, maybe out of care, they will tell you, boss, we know there is some good road, a lot of people are going in this road, why are you taking a different road? You don't know what is there. So they will definitely say a big no. And then if you still pursue to do things, they will start criticizing. They will identify all negative things in your activities and they'll tell you that. If you still proceed and when you become phenomenally successful, the entire society will stand behind you and will say, I know this guy had this potential. I knew that from a very young age. He had that fire in him. His hard work, his dedication, his passion. I knew that. So don't give a damn about society. Don't give a damn about anyone else, what others will think about you, until unless you are not disturbing their dream and their life. And people ask the opportunity cost, the money part. I'm not saying money is not required. Money is very much required. It is required to live a comfortable life. Say one fine day, the constituency where I live in, we went to clean a plot, an area with a JCP because people from that area were requesting us to do that. A guy who was initiating, he called me and said, I'm there. I went there, that guy was not there. Then I called him, he didn't pick my call. In 5 minutes, that guy came with another guy on his shoulder with one woman next to him in an auto. The auto comes here and then suddenly this woman gets out of the auto, she cries and she runs. And then he said, take this guy. I said, why? He said, he's dead. I said, okay, I didn't ask anything. We took that guy, they have a very small house. We put him in top of the mat and I came out and asked, what happened 5 minutes before I was talking to you? He said, no, I was also waiting for you. This guy came, parked his bike and said, hi, how are you? And he went inside. 2 minutes, his wife came and said, something happened to him. He just fell down like this. I went, both of us took him to the doctor and he's dead. He's no more. That really hit me. What are we talking about? You might be the richest person in the world or you might be the poorest person in the world. If death knocks you like this, what can you do with the money that you have? You can't do much. Probably if you get a disease, if you have money, you can get treated in a bigger hospital. If you don't have, you can get treated in a smaller hospital. But if you really don't know when it will go off, you can't do much. Money can't buy even a single moment in your life. So don't give utmost priority to money. It is also a priority, but not the utmost priority. One, identify what exactly you want to do in your life. Two, write down that in a piece of paper. Put it in a flowchart because when you write, the whole universe will help you. Three, use your education wisely and try to create opportunities, improve your skills towards that direction. Four, money is not the utmost priority. It cannot buy even a single moment in your life, even though it is required. Five, don't give a damn about what others think about you or what society thinks. Just follow your heart. If you have a synergy between all these five things, success will reach you. Thank you. Namaskar.